Barrels are to be left alone and not hurled, kicked, tossed, or in any way moved around.
Rock and stone!
Are you a fan of caves? Are you a fan of Left 4 Dead? Are you a fan of Minecraft? Are you a fan of procedurally generated gameplay? Gameplay that requires a lot of teamwork and a little sprinkle of humour. Oh, and dwarves. Yes, Deep Rock Galactic, a game that I have been, quite honestly, addicted to since its recent free weekend a couple of months ago. It's a four-man, or should I say four-dwarven, co-op game where you play in procedurally generated caves, you have to mine certain minerals, there's a couple of game modes that we'll get into, and there's four essential classes to the game, each with their own quirks. Oh, and how could I forget? Loads and loads of aliens, all in different varieties and flavours that are going to try and kill you. So let's get into Deep Rock Galactic. So how does it all work? Well, at its heart, Deep Rock Galactic is an alien FPS-based shooter. It sounds a bit generic, but it's the mission types, it's the procedurally generated caves that we're going to be trouncing through, and it's also the class-based teamwork. We've got four classes here. We've got the scout, we've got the gunner, we've got the driller and the engineer. And every mission will be extremely different, and there's four difficulty modes. We've got Hazard 1, Hazard 2, Hazard 3, Hazard 4, Hazard 5. As you can imagine, each difficulty gets a little bit harder. But before we get into the game modes of Deep Rock Galactic, I just want to touch on the classes and their general utility, what you can expect, and my general opinion of them. So first up we've got the Gunner, probably my favourite class in the game. The clue is in the name, he's killing the aliens with his big ass guns. The Gunner's got a couple of useful tools in his arsenal. The first up is the Zipline. The zipline's basically a rope where you can shoot it at rocks, shoot it over crevasses, shoot it up at a certain angle so the players can traverse over big gullies, up a certain angle that wouldn't necessarily be available without digging your way there manually. And it's also a useful tool because when you're on the zipline you can still shoot, so a good tactic in my experience is to hop onto the zipline, shoot at the aliens that are below you, because unless they're projectile based enemies they can't get to you, so it's a good little tactic to just, like I said, I call it zipline scumming, so it's a very useful tool, one that should never be neglected and is very handy in some certain game modes, so yeah, very important tool, the zipline. And the second tool is the shield, basically a force field that you can chuck down that gives you a few seconds of relief from incoming damage. I've had multiple times where a game has been saved thanks to a very tactical shield throw, so there's a lot of debate in the community as to if the gunner is that useful compared to the other classes, but if it wasn't for that shield, then I would have had so many games that would have just been wiped. Wiped clean because we all got our asses beat. So, yes, shield, very useful, gunner, has his place. If you like destroying stuff with big ass guns, then the gunner may be for you. Next up we've got the driller, what I would call a hard to master class to play it effectively, but also a very easy class, one that's very useful, one that might not feel like you're doing too much, but with the right tools and the right perks, he can be a very big force to be reckoned with. As the name implies, yet again, he's got two big ass drills where he can very quickly drill through any surface in the game. The main purpose of the driller is to carve little passageways, safe places for the team to traverse. Due to the nature of procedural generation, a lot of the time there isn't a clear way to go in these caves, so a driller will come along, he'll say, "Hold my beer, I'm going to drill us straight to where we need to go," and that works the same for the escape pod. A lot of the time you're in deep in a cave, you've done the objective here, and you're thinking, "Oh, how are we going to get back safely and quickly?" The driller will just say, "Again, hold my second beer, I'm going to drill straight to the escape pod." And that is the role of the driller, making safe passageways, making sure the team knows where to go. He's very effective. He also comes with a satchel charge so he can do a lot of explosive damage. He can configure the satchel charge to be either damaged based or rock clearing based. So if you want to make large holes in rocks, much like in real life with TNT, he can do that. So a lot of utility to the driller, And he's got a couple of really cool weapons as well, the plasma gun and the cryo gun. To be honest, I'm not very well versed in those guns, so I don't want to say the merits of them too much, because to be honest, like I said, I'm rubbish at them. I don't play the driller much, but he is a very, very good class. When you've got a pro driller on your team, you will know about it, trust me. And taking the third spot is the engineer, one of the more important roles in the game. Like the gunner, he has a couple of important tools in his arsenal, and the first up is the platform gun. The purpose of the platform gun is to shoot platforms, little burgers I call them, little burger buns that can be shot onto the ceiling, shot onto walls, underneath the minerals where the players need to get to. Now, most of the time, the minerals are going to be on the ceiling of caves, high up on walls where you it will take you ages to mine to manually, but thankfully, thanks to the scout grappling hook, he can just zip his way up there instantly, mine what he needs to mine, and yeah, platforms are super handy and should never be neglected if you're playing engineer. Please engineers, if you're new, please use your platform guns as they are so important. They can also be configured to almost negate full damage as well, so very useful tools. They should never be neglected. Please use your platforms. Much like Team Fortress 2, the name engineer normally implies sentry guns, and yes, we've got a sentry gun. Or even two if you've configured it that way in your personal configuration. The sentry gun shoots aliens. It almost acts as like another dwarf, so if you've got a four-man team with a sentry gun, you're almost, not always, it almost feels like a five-man team. Very useful, very deadly, very cool. The engineer is the scout's best friend. Without his platforms, the poor scout can't always get to the ceiling stuff, the stuff on the high walls. So, again, please encourage any new guys playing. Be kind to them. Just say, hey man, I notice you're not using your platforms. Would you mind placing one for me? Be friendly. We're all nice in a Deep Rock Galactic community. And lastly, we have everyone's favourite, the scout. Even though the scout is probably the weakest in terms of health points in the team, he has the most important utility. A good scout can really, really save the day and make everyone's life that much easier. The main tool in the scout's arsenal is his grappling hook. He can zip around the whole map, just going here, going there, escaping from enemies quickly, getting the minerals on the wall, if there's an engineer platform. And he's a very good all-rounder, very powerful. The scout also carries a flare gun, which is another important tool. He shoots his big flares that light up the caves like a Christmas tree. The caves on Hoxes are very dark and very dreary, so a scout that isn't firing off his flares is a naughty boy. We need to see where we're going, folks. You'll know you're playing with a good scout when he's kiting the aggro off of you. He'll be zipping to the platforms, grabbing all of the minerals, just doing a lot of the heavy lifting. A good scout that's paying attention, knows what he's doing, lighting the way. It's a real good day at the office when the scout is a very good, knowledgeable player. But, and this goes for all of the other classes in the game, none of the classes are locked to experience level. Even if you are new, you can still have fun with these classes. You can even play without some of the classes. That's the beauty of Deep Rock Galactic. It doesn't matter what the team comp is, as long as people are using their utility, sticking with the team, more importantly, having fun, communicating, then you'll never be sort of locked out. Even if you had four drillers, four gunners, you're going to be able to complete your mission. And like I said, that's what I love about this game. It's so easy to get into, so easy to become experienced, and it's a great way to make friends because we're all trying to do the same mission together. It's just a fantastic bit of synergy going on every mission. Procedural generated caves, just wow. And that is the classes. Oh, and I must not forget the scout's grenades. Sorry, before we stop on the classes, the scout carries IFG grenades, which basically creates another little force field like the shield. It slows aliens down, so when you get swarmed or if you're in a tunnel, chuck an IFG grenade down, it will slow them little bastards down so you can shoot them all dead. And that's the scout, and that closes the classes. Very fun, lots of room to grow, and yes, don't be afraid to play the classes you want because no one's going to shout at you. This isn't Rainbow Six Siege where you're going to be yelled at for, why are you playing a driller with flamethrower? Or, why are you being a gunner with a minigun? No, Everyone is friendly. This is the friendliest player base I've ever seen in all of my years of gaming. So yes, please have fun with your classes. So now that you've heard all about the classes, it's only taken us 10 minutes. Shall we get into some game modes? So in every game of Deep Rock Galactic, regardless of the mode, you've got a primary objective and a secondary objective. The secondary objective just gives you a little bonus. Even though it's been a long mission on Magma Core and you really, really cannot be bothered to collect the rest of the fossils, please always do the secondary objectives because it's really worth it. So what are the primary objectives? Well, this is where we get into the game modes, and first up we've got Mining Expedition. Mining Expedition is pretty straightforward. We're after a green mineral called Morkite. We have to get a certain amount of Morkite in a mining expedition, and once we're all done, we simply call Molly, the little moving minecart, and we are done. We're off. We're moving back to the escape pod, and that is Mining Expedition. Pretty straightforward, probably the most easiest mission, depending on the enemies and the difficulty, but yes, pretty straight up, says what it says on the tin. The next up is Egg Hunt, where we have to hunt down alien eggs in the map. Generally speaking, when you fish out an egg, it causes what I would call a mini horde. So can be quite dicey, those missions, but also very fun. A lot of the time, the egg nests are in hard to reach places, so this is where the utility of the players come in. If there's an egg nest on the ceiling, well, better get some platforms up, better get some drillers doing their job and fish out that bad boy egg. So yes, very cool mission. If you fancy punishing yourself, you could play Elimination Mode, where you have to hunt down the alien dreadnoughts. Dreadnoughts hide in their alien cocoon, and we have to shoot them out of it. They're very angry, they're very mad, they've got armor everywhere, and you have to shoot the armor down, get the armor down first before you can get to the health bar, and yes, very tough mode. Normally you have to kill two or three dreadnoughts, and yes, very tough, very tricky, but yet again, bundles of fun with a great team. Next up we've got a salvage operation. As you'll probably see from our footage, we keep seeing a little robot. Well, that robot is a moving minecart called Molly. That's where the players deposit all of their minerals that they collect on mission. Molly follows us around and she's a bit of a trope within the community. Good old Molly, we all love Molly. But a salvage operation, we have to find legs of mini Mollies. Little tiny minecarts. The legs are scattered around the map, and it's the player's objective to basically find these legs, attach them to normally two or three mini mollies. And once all of the mini mollies, or mini mules as they're properly known, have been repaired successfully, we have to uplink to mission control. This part of the salvage operation can get really tough. It's basically a horde-based sort of wave system we've got going on here. We have to stand in a radius that's defined by a big green floating circle. All of the players have to stand in this circle while the uplink links up to mission control. You'll see a progress bar on screen. The more players in the radius means the quicker it's going to go. Because while all of this is happening, yes, there's lots of aliens coming at us, so it can get really tough doing this part of the mission. I've seen a lot of salvage missions just go bust because we've become overrun by aliens, a giant detonator has come and blown us up. Very frantic, very fun. It's always a pleasure to complete a salvage operation because not only is finding the legs of the mini mules quite hard, the final wave defense is even harder, so it's always a mini celebration when you complete a salvage op. And my favorite game mode left for last, it is point extraction. What point extraction is, we have a giant minehead that comes down from the ceiling. It's a big armed with sentry guns platform where we have to go out into the cave and find some big blueing gems called arquarks. In a point extract mission, we have to find a set amount of arquark gems. Thankfully, they're easy to spot due to their little blue glowing stones on the walls. To be honest, I don't really know why point extract is my favourite game mode. I think it's just having that central hub of the minehead. Even if stuff goes hairy, you can always fall back to the minehead because it's got sentry guns. Granted, they don't do much damage to the aliens, but I don't know, there's just a central feeling to point extract. It's a really comfortable mission type. Even though it's very difficult, it can get very hairy, especially on the higher difficulties, but I just like the feel of point extract. A very, again, I keep saying every game mode is fun, but there's something about point extract I can't quite put my finger on. I have much love for point extracts. I've played with boys that only play point extract. It's a very fun type of mission. So now that we know about the classes and we know about the game modes, well, what is the meat and potatoes of the actual game? What's going to make us keep coming back and playing Deep Rock Galactic? And the answer to that is sheer fun gameplay. Thanks to those procedurally generated caves, we're never going to see the same type of cave. There's a few different biomes in the game, ranging from sandblasted corridors, glacial strata, which is an icy map, dense biozone, which is very moist, very dense, very fungus bogs, where the caves are full of sticky goo, and a couple of others. Oh, and magma core, which makes everyone's day a bad day. You'll never see the same cave twice. Even though they're the same biome, you'll always see spectacular caverns, tight winding tunnels. And group all of this with many different alien types. We've got little grunts that are numerous, little tiny swarmers that are annoying little pests that chomp at your feet, big detonators that are big bullet sponges but will create an enormous cavern when you blow them up. Many different enemy types, ranging from easy to hard. All of this team play, all of this synergy, all of this random procedural generatedness, if that's a word. There's always something new to experience. Just this amazing team synergy just makes every game just feel new and fresh every time. And it's the reason while I've been playing this for 130 hours plus now, and probably more by the time this goes out, I just cannot get enough of it. It works. Have you ever bought a game where your expectations are low? Not to discredit any game out there, but where you buy a game because it's cheap, you equally amount that to the amount of gameplay you're going to get from it. Well, Deep Rock Galactic really blew my expectations big time. I knew it would because of the concept. Me personally, I like tunnels. There's something about tunnels that intrigue me. Dwarfs, I'm not a huge fan of, but they make it work in this game. The humour is spectacular, very charming, very funny. Just something about the European voice acting of the dwarfs that's quite cute as well. Everything just works in this game. It's very sweet, and the team play itself is just phenomenal. Everything just gels. I would say to you, buy this game on Steam outright, and if you don't like it by that 2-hour Steam limit, then I would be very surprised. Obviously, this game won't be for everyone, but I implore you to give it a try because it's spectacular. Spectacular fun that's always fresh, always unique, and that is Deep Rock Galactic. It's a phenomenal game. It really, truly is. You can spend hours leveling up your classes, upgrading the guns with the minerals that you collect on mission. Those can be spent on cosmetics for your characters. No ugly microtransactions or nothing like that. It's all in game, don't worry. When you complete certain milestones in game, you will also be rewarded with perk points, which can be spent for your characters as well. Each class gets 4 perk slots, and when you, what I would call, prestige your character, you get an extra perk slot. These perks can range from not dying instantly. It's a perk called Iron Will, where you are allowed to stay alive for 8 seconds. This gives you a little tiny window to find health so you don't die. A couple of other perks include resupplying quickly, having your magazine refilled when you resupply, a couple of other little ones. So there's lots of little configurations to play with your character, with your weapons. So there's always something to work towards. And going back to that prestige mode, sorry, when you get to level 25 in your character, you can basically prestige your character. It's called a promotion, and this gives you a little star. You have bronze stars, silver stars, and gold stars, and you can earn up to 3 of each. So if you see someone with 3 gold stars, you know they've been in the game a long time and they know their stuff. So yes, even though the game appears simple, there's a lot to bite off and chew. In Deep Rock Galactic, I love it. It has to be my game of the year, and one of those games that's going to be a seminal game. A seminal game being like Half-Life. One where you think of it, you think, wow, what a spectacular game. One that's going to stick around for years, and I'm looking so, so forward to the future. And before I close out here, I want to do a couple of shout-outs, and that is to the developers. You are superstars. These developers are working their asses off. They're the most in-tune developers I've ever seen. They're always posted on Reddit, on their Discord. They directly respond to criticism and suggestions on Reddit. It's something great to see in the gaming community, something that the big boys should really pay attention to and give your sound designer or sound team a promotion, because your sound design is some of the best I've ever heard. The music, the synthwave tracks, the gun design, the acoustics in the cave. When you hear that gunner's revolver go clap, clap, the echo, the everything works. Even I've seen a post from the sound designer on Reddit. He says, if there's no one complaining about the sound, I know I've done a good job. And everything is fantastic in this game. Shout out to those developers, because they're working their butts off and it's fantastic to see. And a second shout out is to the community itself. When you play online games, you're always subject to playing with just idiots, just people that are trolling, people that are useless. But I don't know what's happening with Deep Rock Galactic. In all of my time playing it, in 130 plus hours, I've only encountered one person being a bit of an idiot shooting the teammates. But other than that, everyone has had fantastic teamwork. People talk on the microphones. I'm not quite sure what's happening here. It's weird. It's an anomaly. Everyone is a superstar that plays this game. It's such a strange thing to see. And it's great fun. It's amazing. And that's the thing with games these days. You don't just buy a game to have the game. When you buy a ticket into a game, you're now entering into communities, aren't you? We've got subreddits, we've got Discords, and also live streaming. This is a game that I've been live streaming a lot, and I've had so much fun. And the community around the game as a whole, as I keep saying, is fantastic. Everyone's willing to help. It's just such a positive place. The future of the game is looking strong. Constant development updates, the team's letting us know what's going on. Everyone's being positive, everyone's having fun, everyone's working together, and I cannot thank you all enough for being so great, developers and community in general. Everyone's just good. I'm speaking from the heart here, I'm not cutting this audio. It's just so much fun. And that is Deep Rock Galactic, a true bundle of love. Everything about the game, community, gameplay, repetitiveness, I love it. I truly love it. And I hope you guys check this game out, or at least give it a chance. Even though it might seem like it's a bit of a tropey gameplay style, perhaps horde shooters or alien shooters, please give it at least those steam 2 hours, because if you don't love it as much as I do, then fair play. But for those that do love it, for those that haven't heard of this game at all, honestly, please, please, please give this a try, because if you love it as much as me, then I know I've done my job introducing you to a new game. So, and yes, that is my long, gone longer than I expected review of Deep Rock Galactic. And yes, as you know by now, I love the game. It's my favourite game, outright, my favourite game. Yes, and those are big words, and I hope it can be one of your favourite games. And here we are again, it's another 20 plus minutes of me talking. Hopefully you've enjoyed what I've had to say, and as I said, hopefully I've introduced you to a game you may not have heard of. So thank you for your time once again, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers, guys.